Gerald Celente is our guest. He'll be with us for 20 minutes of the next hour. So for the next 45 minutes, trendsresearch.com. He is an American trends forecaster, publisher of the Trends Journal, business consultant, and author who makes predictions about global financial markets and other events of historical importance. And he's described himself as a political atheist and a citizen of the world. He has appeared as a guest on Oprah Winfrey's show, Glenn Beck, you name it, NBC Nightly News, trendsresearch.com. And again, it was a dead cat bounce. He said by the end of 2010, you're going to know we're in a depression. And every real housing number, jobless, classical benchmark, we were in a depression. And when the government didn't announce a depression in December, some people said, oh, look, Celente said we'd be in a depression. Well, now they're saying it's the greatest recession. And the former head of the private Federal Reserve told Meet the Press, don't worry, we won't default. We'll just print more money. That is a default. Just unbelievable things are now being admitted. I wish that I was wrong. I wish Gerald was wrong. But he's been absolutely right. And he had the guts, the cojones, the huevos, to actually put a date on it. And so what happened is we were in the big depression by the time he said we would be, but they said that no, everything's fine. And still they're saying, well, we're in the greatest recession, but don't worry, everything's going to be okay, as they simply stall while they put their police state in. Gerald Celente, break it down for us, please, sir.
Well, you hit on it, Alex. They're covering it up. This came out of Bloomberg yesterday. It's not in today's Wall Street Journal. It's not in that toilet paper record, the New York Times. And it's not even in the Financial Times. Wall Street aristocracy got $1.2 trillion in Fed secret loans. That's what they did. As all these banks like J.P. Morgan Chase, like the Goldman Sachs gang, like the Citigroup criminals, like the Barclay bandits, who all said, hey, our balance sheets are okay, things are really fine, they were getting tens of billions of dollars worth of loans. Alex, loans like you would get, and maybe I'll charge you 1%. Because you're one of the white shoe boys. They keep propping up this Ponzi scheme, and they keep lying to us. And the only reason these numbers just came out is because of the Dodd-Frank bill. But there's that clause in there, you know, the insanity clause. We gotta wait 2 years before we release these numbers because, you know, we don't want people to see the real truth. And they may pull their money out of these criminal organizations. So they give us this baloney that that's why they can't put out these numbers. And this is only what we're seeing. Look at Obama. Look where he's on that vacation again, you know. Where did he spend last night? Oh, at the prostitute's house. That's right, the guy that owns NBC, Comcast. It's all one club, and we're not in it. And you were talking about, you know, Venezuela, North Korea. No. This is fascism USA. I said it when Obama got elected. I said it when you did the Obama deception. And that's what it is. It's the merger of state and corporate powers. You pointed out all the breaks that the big guys get, like General Electric, you know, like all of them. They get the allowances while they're screwing the little people. You mentioned it, the lemonade stands, the cheese. How about that Rawsome Foods incident that you reported on a couple of weeks ago in Los Angeles, where the food Gestapo came in and busted them, and they were only supposed to take representative samples of it's a club. They weren't even selling this stuff. You belong to a club. And what do? A representative sample happened to be every piece of article in the joint. So now as I'm speaking, look at the price of gold. $1,889 an ounce. And we had forecast at the beginning of this year, I'm on all the major media, $2,000 an ounce. Why is it going up? One simple reason. The entire global financial system is collapsing, and only the little children believe that it's going to be saved.
And let me throw this at you. Let me throw this at you, because you did predict 2,000 by the end of the year, a bold prediction. That was a long time ago you made that prediction. And it's because you've been proven right that they're not going to be inviting you on all these shows, and all these newspapers aren't going to interview you that called you a pessimist porno dealer. Just like the Pew Research showed, Ron Paul is getting less coverage than any other candidate, including candidates that have dropped out. Because in reality, he's in the top three candidates. He's a major front runner, and he's been right. So they're going to ignore him. But when you're a liar, well, then they'll put you on national television.
It's because it's the houses of prostitution. They're just there to serve their masters. You just saw Obama make a trip to the master's house at Comcast this just yesterday, up at Martha's Vineyard. And that's all it is, and I'm not a member. You know, I told you, I think, you know, there also might be, I think maybe they don't like the way I dress, and I don't wear those Brooks Brothers suits, you know? And maybe this Salenti doesn't ring right with them, or that Bronx accent. So I'm going to become maybe Jay Endicott Prescott III. And if that doesn't work, maybe Josh O'Shaughnessy Greenberg. Then I'd really be brilliant, you know?
Why don't you just start talking like Thurston Howell the Third, and change your name to Winford Springfield Dimitri Rockefeller the 17th? Oh, Buffy, look, why don't you start talking like that?
Yeah, they got these guys on CNBC every day, you know. I mean, you can't, it's like, it's a comic. So going back to what's going on, let's look what's going on over in Europe. The game is over. They're talking about euro bonds. Merkel doesn't want to do it. Nobody really does. So that's collapsing. Where are they going to get the money? They're at zero interest rates. So as we're talking, the stock market took a little pop up today. Why? This is what they have the gall to say. On the good news that Ben Bernanke may announce QE3 by the end of the week. The good news, great, more digital money, not worth the paper it's not printed on. We'll keep those interest rates near zero. So all you people out there that used to put money in the bank and think you were going to get a return on it, you're not going to get anything unless you invest in the Ponzi scheme called Wall Street. The whole system is collapsing. And you mentioned about Biden being over in China, sucking up and bowing down. There's a photo of him last week. He's walking down the gangplank, you know, this, what, Air Force Two, you know, this plane that's big enough to move half a city, you know? And he's holding the hand of this young, attractive woman. I say, wow, who's that? And at the end, it's his granddaughter, Naomi. And here, you know, they got all these guys saluting the red carpet. What kind of baloney is this? I thought he's going over there to do business. He takes his granddaughter with him, you know? And who's paying for this stuff? It's the same like Hillary Clinton. She sent Chelsea to the soccer game, you know, to cheer on the team. Everybody get this straight. You have a royalty in this country. Harvard, Princeton, Yale, the Bullets, Banks, and Bombs Club. And the only time when they want you is for cannon fodder and to pick your pocket. So people that believe that you're going to have change you could believe in, whether voting for the Republicans and the Democrats, you better grow up if you haven't grown up by now.
Absolutely. I want to play a clip for you and get your take on it. To have Greenspan on Meet the Prostitutes, to adopt your term that's, I'm noticing, is now becoming popularized. So you've actually coined a phrase that's now going to be in popular use. They say that's a real sign of true influence, so congratulations. Prostitutes, and I hope our listeners will start using it. He was on Meet the Prostitutes, and he said, hey, don't worry, we're not going to default, we'll just print money. And they had the former White House financial advisor on there, at Goolsbee, and he literally got shaken up and couldn't believe that Greenspan just said that. So they've got the chutzpah, the arrogance, to come right out in the open and say, we're going to devalue the dollar down to nothing. Let's play that clip. Here it is.
Are U.S. Treasury bonds still safe to invest in?
Very much so. I think there's a... This is not an issue of credit rating. The United States can pay any debt it has because we can always print money to do that. So there is zero probability of default.
What? And he's up there with a skull and bones. When we come back, we'll get Gerald Celente's take on that. And the skull and bones guy, who's the other guest with him, literally starts smiling. You could tell as an adrenaline rush, and you see a little bit of flush come to his face. He actually blushes, like he goes, my gosh, that was just said. And that's what Gerald was just getting into. QE3 is like another bullet in the head. We'll explain what this means on the other side. The destruction of your pensions. I mean, when does it end? Because they're old men and look like they've been put in a microwave and are wearing suits, we've got to just let them gut and destroy everything. What does it signify that they're talking about just printing money to a Weimar Republic level and that they're openly talking about QE3, Gerald?
Well, again, now what is gold at? Now it's $1,891 an ounce. So that's what they're doing. Maybe you remember in the old Weimar Republic, they had the wheelbarrows. Maybe we could have Bernanke barrows now. So you could load them up. We'll put bungee cords on them to hold the money in so you could buy a loaf of bread. There's not one thing I agree with that guy Rick Perry over there that's running for president, except this one thing about him saying that Bernanke should be brought up for treason. And so should this other guy, Greenspan. And by the way, everything that these guys predicted has been wrong, just for the record, but they keep bringing them back for their expertise. They are robbing the people in front of our eyes. I read to you that piece from Bloomberg that was reported yesterday. $1.2 trillion going to J.P. Morgan Chase, going to Credit Suisse, Societe Generale, Barclays, and not a nickel for you or a nickel for me.
No, no, our tax money had to pay for this. By the way, MSNBC got hundreds of millions of dollars. And as you said earlier, and I have the article here, who does he go visit but the head of Comcast that owns MSNBC, and literally the subsidiaries they took control of are getting government money. And so they talk about other people having state-run media. We have state-run media. It's just foreign banker-run through the state. I mean, it's ridiculous.
It's state-run media. You have it. By the way, if anybody wants to get a glimpse of what's going on over in Libya, I suggest you tune in to RT, you know, Russia Today, because they're the only ones that are giving another side of the story. And just like the prostitutes got us into that Iraq war. Remember that one? Remember Saddam Hussein's weapons of mass destruction? Remember Katie Couric on the Today Show walking across that map on the floor with that other prostitute? What's that guy, that former general they always dredge up all the time to send the people to war? And they do it all. Remember the New York Times, the toilet paper, a record about Saddam Hussein's yellow cake and them aluminum tubes. They're liars. All they're doing is what every prostitute does. They serve their masters. And if you were to put them all together, you wouldn't come up with one pair of cojones among them all. They're all suck-ups and sellouts, and they're selling out this country. And your children out there, they're going to be next, because the next war, they're going to need more cannon fodder. So keep pumping out those babies and keep spending your money for these wars. What are we going into now? Oh, 9/11, big celebrations are coming up in New York City in a couple of weeks.
But CNN's reporting that the 9/11 victims and the first responders are barred from being there. That's right. Stay with